Now the chapter is food production from plants and methods of management. So food production from plants, that is the agriculture in which food grains, fruits, vegetables are grown, cultivated. So India is an agricultural country. So it is the chief occupation for many people in India. So there is a huge population in India which needs a lot of food grains are to be produced every year. So the production of food from plants and the different methods of management to get high yields, good yield out of the plants are discussed in this chapter. So when the plants are sown, grain plants, cereal plants or millet plants or gram plants that are sown in the fields, they will take some time to grow. So that is called as that duration of the crop. If we know the duration of the crop, we can estimate how much yield it gives in 1 year. That means it will give an idea for how many crops we can grow, we can go for in 1 year of time. So based on the duration, the crops may be divided to two groups, like short term crops, long term crops. So short-term crops means the crops that will complete their life, that is from the sowing to the harvesting, it will complete in 100 days. So below that period it is called a short-term crop, and long-term crops which will take nearly 180 days for completing the cropping process. So that is long-term crops. So examples of short-term crops are green, gram and black gram, etc. And 180 days, these long term crops, examples jowar, millets like jowar and red gram, etc. So these are the examples of long term crops. So the crops are also classified into kharif and rabi crops. So kharif crops, these are the crops that are grown in rainy season. So why they are grown in rainy season? In some areas, the availability of water depends upon the rainfall. Because if the water source like some river or canal is not available, or even the bore water is not available, they are dependent on rainwater. During rainy season, the rainwater is collected in the ponds and lakes, which can be supplied to the fields. So it can be irrigation. So by that, the agriculture can be carried out, and such crop which is exclusively planted in the rainy season is called as kharif crop. So rabi crop, it is a winter crop. So these crops are grown in the winter season, rabi crops. So anyway, we will learn about this kharif and rabi crops. We'll learn much more details about these two in the coming topics. So now let us see what factors will make the farmers to decide whether they can go their crop for kharif or rabi. So if they have decided for certain crop like wheat or rice, so how can they decide whether to go for kharif season or rabi season? So decide this, there are some factors which influence or which affect the growth of plants in a specific season. So that is the flowering. So scientists have studied that flowering plays an important role in the duration of the plant, in proper growth of the plant. So that is the harvest of the plant. So what is that observation? So actually, when will the flowering takes place? When the plant is attain height, when it is having some 6 to 7 leaves, and when it comes out of the ground and will have certain height, then it may start flowering. So in most of the plants, it is observed that the flowering takes place in the night times. So duration of night is also important. Duration of night. So it is observed that in many plants, the flowering is more when the duration of the night is more than 12 and a half hours. So if it is selected that certain seasons like winter, where the duration of night is more, in such cases plants like wheat, maize and cotton So they show more flowering. So by that, the quick maturation and quick fertilization, so formation of the grains or formation of the fruits in very quick period. So that is, the night time is one of the factor. The duration of the night is an important factor for the flowering of many plants. But it is also observed that in some plants like soya bean, the night duration has no effect on the flowering of soya bean. So it is observed in some cases, but many cases it is observed that the night duration is an important factor, so which will promote the flowering in plants. So by that, their duration will be decided, and they may give the duration will be less when there is more flowering in the night times, when the night duration is more than 12.5 hours. So on basing these factors, the farmers decide whether they can, if they decided to take one gram plant or any cereal, they can choose whether it is better to go for a kharif or a rabi for the particular crop. So now let us see that growing paddy and the agricultural practices in the growth of paddy. So paddy, it gives rice. Growing paddy is a very old agricultural practice. So it dates back to Mesolithic period, 9000 to 8000 years BC. So that was observed, that cultivation of rice, paddy, during that time. Even in India, in Harappan period, like 2300 years BC, also observed that cultivation of paddy. So paddy is grown as either as a kharif or a rabi crop. Kharif or rabi crop. So if we see the Indian map, so it is grown from Rajasthan to Arunachal Pradesh and Jammu Kashmir, from the north to that Kerala extreme south. So if you see the length and breadth of India, in almost all the states here the rice is grown, the paddy is grown. Not only in India, the paddy is cultivated in other countries like China, Japan and Australia. But in our country, large amount of land is under paddy cultivation, large amount of land. So we take the first place in land, but in production per hectare, Japan's is the first place. So more production, even though the Japan has kept less land in production of paddy, more production per hectare when compared to India. So India is in third place when compared to China. China is also having good production per hectare land. Japan is also having good production per hectare of land. The India stands at last in the production. But whereas in land, India is using more land in the cultivation of paddy.